There we go.
Thing to remember, and part of that was 2 weeks in Japan travelling around. Fantastic. Yeah, it was, except it was on cocaine all the time, I think. And I was too dumb to work it out. So anyway, so a lot of the time I spent on trains and travelling around, and it's just overwhelming. Okay. We stayed in five-star luxury hotels, the carpet was this deep.
Well, we won't be, I think we're in about fours, but that's okay.
Four in Japan is 10 here.
Yeah. The travel consultant said it's very neat, it's very tidy and clean, okay. And you'll be fine and happy.
But when I had to pay for my own accommodation the last night at Osaka, I was in one of these little tiny rooms, the bed was here.
Judy,
yeah?
You got any idea where Sue's painting might be from last week?
We're two of us in a room.
Oh.
Have we got row?
No, that's not them, is it? Whereabouts is it?
I'll be turning the gas wall probably at the end.
Yeah.
Because we've had a lot of trouble with, some trouble with lack of respect from the other group.
Are you inspired by anything, Steve, or you're just...
I'm just using the patterns or whatever colours that I've pulled out of it. So there's a couple of directions that I've used.
Uh-huh.
There's a squarish bit over there. There's the maroon. First thing was the maroon from those triangles. And that goes across that way. There's a bit of green there. And this goes with that, and that goes with that sort of thing. And that's pretty much it.
It's not fast. It's right behind you.
Oh, well, don't worry about it. Get more than 2Ks out of that paint, my friend.
Look at that.
Oh, dollars and cents, that's all I can see.
Just squandering it. Squandering it.
So you've got a lot of medium in that, have you?
I've got impasto medium to give it a bit of bulk so I can push it around a bit, and gloss medium so it'll slide and not be too dull.
Okay.
Okay, where else would you put
them? I'll look behind the door, the other door in there.
Yeah, we have
that. Yeah, that's the one. Sorry. And that one?
Yeah. Pretty much.
Start on some, you need to start, just start on some paper. As
I'll watch this.
Oh, I'll be in the front of this set. So I'm using the blues and the reds and the green to create my tertiaries.
Ah, do you hear that?
So tertiaries are the secondary paints that link up the rest of it.
So if you're using the blue, the green and the red, if you mix those three together,
It'll create the tertiary.
It'll create the tertiary.
To go with the other ones that you've got. So your browns, the browny, greyy colours.
But you have to mix equal amounts, because if you mix too much blue, no, it doesn't matter.
It just depends on, you mix it in.
So you know then they will always,
right, right.
They'll be
if
right to get
crap,
those colours.
They'll be the ones that will work together because
they're linked.
They're linked, so there's a group, there's a unity in there. So they only, it's the right colour if it looks all right. If you don't like it, you change it to something else. Now, see, I'm whipping it like, sort of whipping it like butter. It's sort of working wet on wet. But you get some nice colour variations doing that.
No, boss.
It will be chilled. It will be fine. I shall find it.
Yes.
Yep.
You're pushing him to the brink, Judy.
Yes.
I can see he's going to snap.
You can see it now.
I can see it.
Tension
in your arm.
Yeah, where it is. Have a look at those. So you can see, give you some idea of where we're going.
Oh.
Okay, so what's coming out are some nice greys that work nicely with the blues. So I would probably put that grey and the red-yellow looking particularly attractive. And that blue there I like too. The green, that red I think needs to probably come out, and I'm going to add some of the blue down here to get more of the grey. It's rather lovely.
Are you thinking about the golden mean, or are you? It's
oh,
just
absolutely.
Happens. Just happens.
I will
die.
Never think about the golden mean, ever. If it turns up. It turns up because
okay.
It works. But there's lots of other ones. But they are things that. If it turns up, it turns up because that's sort of where the. So as I said, that it just sort of happens to look all right.
Okay, so it's good for learning when you're learning too.
It's something to understand, and there were definitely artists that used it in the Renaissance. It was used and in the academies
mm-hmm.
for a long time after that. And it was used as a formula for making art, where there was a prescriptive
okay.
time of.
Oh really? No, those ones there aren't. I checked those ones.
Did you?
Yeah. Have another look though, I could have.
Awesome. Trowel.
There we are. So that gives you a nice even finish there. That's it. As I said, I've had to take extra steps to protect the works, and
yeah, that one
we're
did.
Not getting respected as we should.
Are we reading a note to the other teacher?
Oh, that's. She's a school teacher, so I don't want that sort of culture of
yes.
ticky-tacky, that childlike behaviour that carries on, as I've seen in school. So we
yeah.
just take precautions.
She's very hippie-ish, though.
Yeah, but she's an art... You can see the class, the kids' classes.
The bigger
are
ones, isn't it?
She's a school art teacher, and so she's very much a school art sort of person. But it doesn't matter. We just have to look after our...
Yeah, just it's called respect, isn't it?
It's called respect, it's not happening, so we
yeah.
just have to be aware of that. And it's not the first time.
But things being damaged, aren't
they? Mm. Oh, over time, yes. Things just put aside or splattered on. Or... Yeah, see how it's
yep.
just finding the nice bits that come out of it.
Mm.
This looks rather gauche and... Volga, Harrison, the subject of those nice greys. So we'll use that as a base, but we can